is essentially a data shape motion above the string. The way we started is we have them play a slower data shape near the frog and say, okay, lift the board off at the end of each stroke. More towards the sounding point, but it's still a forearm motion. And we go towards the middle of the bow, and then all we have to do is make the bow stand up. I make sure that, again, the thumbs are our enemies in this, that the right thumb is relaxed. One of the things, once they do that, can do that a little bit, I ask them to do this. Hold the bow, lift it up with the pinky, and just let it drop. So that they know that the bow will bounce all by itself. They don't have to bring the bow down and up. So gravity will take care of it. And the elasticity of the bow will bring it back up. Only way to introduce energy is with a detaché motion. We can put it on a scale. Eventually, a chord tone number two. String crossings in the spiccato come with the last motion. This motion goes to the new string. That motion goes to the A string, so that the next motion starts on the A string level. And that's plenty of explanation for the beginning. And I want to make sure that the spiccato stays slow enough. The sautille, we started with a wrist motion in the upper half. And it's just a tremolo with the wrist. I always pull their shirts or sweaters back so I can see this. And I put them in front of a mirror so they can see that it's not this. Or when they start that, then they see it. And then go to the middle of the bow, somewhere between the middle and the balance point, it bounces. And then make them look at the bow. The bow stick bounces a lot. The hair essentially stays on the string. And if they want it louder and more bounce, they have to press with the index finger. And that's a bit counterintuitive, because they think if I say bounce it higher, they lift the bow off the string. Yeah?